We are here to celebrate your 25 years with WWE. To kick it off, we have to ask. There are a ton of stories over the years of people's initial in-person meeting with Mr. McMahon. So what are your memories of the first time chatting with the chairman?
Well, it's funny for me. One of the first, very first time I met Vince was when I was still at WCW. My contract was coming to an end. And, you know, I was trying to gauge interest, I guess you could say. So they took a meeting with me. J.J. Dillon at the time was running talent relations and was kind of in charge of that. And I spoke to J.J. He brought me in for a meeting with Vince. And, you know, I remember coming in and meeting with Vince and thinking, like, one, obviously it's Vince McMahon. So, you know, he has a larger than life presence. And of course it is I guess the ultimate probably meeting that you could take in the business, especially at that time. And it, maybe even more so today, I guess. But you know, going into the meeting, obviously very nervous and hopefully expecting a great outcome, and then getting in there and realizing this guy has no idea who I am. You know, I'm sure he was asked, you know, knowing the situation now, he was asked to take a meeting with a talent. Here's a kid that's, you know, new, up and coming, and they believe, and, you know, his contract's coming up. We'll take a meeting with him and see if he's somebody that you want to bring in. And I don't believe he was aware necessarily of me as a performer or my work, nor should he have been, I guess, probably at that time. But so, you know, we had a very cordial meeting and you know, he just asked me what my plans were and what I was thinking about doing and why I wanted to go there as opposed to, you know, kind of staying where I was and all that kind of stuff. But, you know, I guess the biggest takeaway for me was just a larger than life impression of Vince McMahon that you get. He has a presence, and when you're in a room with him, that presence carries over. And I've seen it in meetings with the biggest, you know, so to speak, heavy hitters in industry and in business, that he's in a room and he carries the room. So it was quite a meeting. It would be a little bit later than that, you know, maybe like a month later, that he would then call me. I think now he was aware of what I was doing, had seen me work. It was after I had performed at Starrcade against Alex Wright. It was one of my, kind of at the very end of my contracts, and he called me right after that to say, look, if you're still interested in coming here, I saw what you did at Starrcade, and I'd like for you to come here.
Wow, what an amazing story. Hearing Vince watch Starrcade, to me, is kind of mind-blowing. That's pretty cool to hear that.
I'm sure he did not watch all of Starrcade. I'm sure somebody showed him a clip. Here's that kid that you met with the other day, and what do you think? And it was great. You know, it was great at that time. You know, 25 years is a long time. And you think it's a funny thing when I think about that story. When Vince called me after Starrcade, I got to Chicago. I was still on the road for WCW, and I got to Chicago. And when I walked into the hotel, I saw one of the agents that was there, and he came running over to me, and he said, hey, the office called, and your mom has been trying to call you all day. And, you know, I was like, oh, my God, I thought something happened, right? So I run over to a bank of payphones to call home, thinking something happened. And, you know, at that time, that's the only way you had to get a hold of people, right? And so sure. I reached out to my mom, who said J.J. Dillon has been calling the house all day, because that's the only number they had for me. So J.J. Dillon has been calling the house all day trying to get a hold of you. So I called J.J., and then J.J. said, hey, Vince is in Boca, Florida. This was like right around the holidays. He's in Boca, but would like to talk to you. Do you have a moment? And he connected me through to Vince, and there you go. So my job was created on a bank of payphones.